Good morning, brothers and sisters, and welcome to the Feast PICC AM session. And yes, you are watching the 10 AM session here on Facebook and YouTube. And we are here to welcome you here at our morning session. My name is Kian, and I have here this beautiful lady. What's your name?
Good morning. Happy Sunday. My name is Annie. We are your live engagers, and we are coming to you live here at the PICC. So, if you're on Facebook or on YouTube, thank you so much for scrolling and stopping, stopping the scroll to be with us. And we're going to be here for a few minutes, and then after that, we're going to have the Mass, and then the worship, and our talk for our today's session. So, Ian, how are you? Happy Easter! It's the third Sunday of Easter. Kumusta kayo lahat? Ay, if you have anything to shout out, like birthday, anniversary, week sali, magpasaya lang kayo this week, just let us know, put it in the comments, and we're going to read your responses.
Awesome. Yep. Any prayer requests as well, like healing prayers or Thanksgiving prayers, or any special petitions that you want us to pray over, just let us know then via chat. You know, if you stop scrolling on Facebook and YouTube, and napadpad kayo dito sa live stream na to, maybe it's not just an accident that you're here. And talagang inadya talaga ni Lord na magkita-kita tayo ngayon para may matutunan ka today. And at the same time, we want to talk to you as well. And, know your insights, and of course, pray for you if you have any prayer intentions. So again, if you are, loving this live stream, please don't forget to share this live stream to your friends and family. You can share this to your wall. At the same time, send this via messenger to your GCs, ganyan. And of course, let us know as well where you are watching from. So if you are watching from Las Piñas, from Bulacan, or even from Poland, or even Madagascar, baka meron din. Let us know, and we'll be glad to give you a big shout-out later.
Yeah, and speaking of shout-out, Kian, we also want to welcome the first-timers. Thank you so much. If you stop scrolling, welcome to the Feast. This can be your home every Sunday. You can join us and fill yourselves with God's love every Sunday.
Yep, and if you are a first-timer, just let us know. Key in, I am a first-timer. And of course, we will be glad to welcome you here and give you a shout-out as well. And we have as well people from the First Timers Ministry who can give you a welcome prayer as well. And you can meet after this session as well via Zoom.
Yeah.
All right. Basta tayo ng konting message. Simula sa baba.
Yes. Simula
from
sa baba.
Janelle Alcaraz, good morning. The Feast Family.
Hi.
Good morning, Janelle.
Joining us from Michelle Madrid.
Yung sounds po nag-echo.
Okay, watching from Cavite. Hello.
Okay, from Raymond Reyes. Good morning, Feast Family. Watching from Pagasinan.
Nako, sarap yung init ng pagmamahal ng Diyos dyan. Ingat kayo dyan, palagi.
Akala lang mainit na dito. Mas mainit pa daw ng pagmamahal.
From Janelle Alcaraz as well. He's saying it's from
Calacasi, Batangas. Okay, from Evangeline Lanterno, blessed Sunday, bro and sister.
And we have a first-timer. Hi, Annabelle Reyes. Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to the Feast.
Alright.
We hope you feel loved today and in the coming weeks.
Awesome. Alright, from Sai Andrada, good morning, watching from Taiwan.
Ni hao.
Yeah, from Via Fuentes, meron echo.
Meron pa din. From Ace, from Facebook, magandang mga feasters. That's Ace from Tondo, Manila. Malet Arobo is watching from Japan.
Welcome. And I hope you enjoy.
Japan, Taiwan, parang masarap yata pumunta dyan.
Sobrang init dito. I came from Legazpi last week. Last week and then just arrived yesterday.
Oh, wow.
Mabawalan doon.
Oh, that's nice.
Mabawalan doon every day. And pagdating ko dito, Parang inaapuyan.
I'm going to go to the house. Keep all those precautions because these are not so. This is like, yun sabi nila, there are four seasons in the Philippines. There's tag init, tag araw, tag pawis, and tag, I don't know what's the other. Tag prito siguro. I don't know.
Tag prito.
Probably. So there you go. So, okay. Our weekly question. That they can answer with us.
Yep, maiksi lang to.
Yes.
You know, if you could describe your past week in one word, what would it be?
Yon.
Yep. Describe your past week in one word.
Yes.
Kung ako,
sige.
Yeah, simulan ko na ha.
Yes,
kasi,
yes. Because you came from Legazpi.
Yeah, Legazpi. And I am a solo traveler. So, pumunta ako doon ng walang kaplano-plano. Hindi ko alam kung ano gagawin ko. Sumakay na lang ako na isang jeep. Hindi ko alam.
Kasi
siya pupunta. Ganyan.
But the thrill of being a solo traveler is there, di ba?
Yep. So talagang, the pros is, syempre, hawak ko yung oras ko.
Yes.
Kaya kong mag-decide kung anong gusto kong gawin. Cons, walang taga-picture. ganyan. And hindi okay. Rin, kabado din ako most of the time. Kasi natatakot ako maligaw.
Yes,
ganyan.
Yes.
Ikaw ba?
Any unforgettable or any tip siguro as a solo traveler that you could give us, especially at this time na ito yung, ganito yung weather natin.
Yep.
And but you still want to go out and explore at least the country.
Yep. So, ang suggestion ko lang is sobrang init talaga. So, please be prepared lang, bring and drink so much water, and at the same time wear light clothes para hindi masyadong mainit, and at the same time wear sunblock para alam mo yun, stay protected tayo sa UV rays, ganyan. And at the same time, kung ikaw ay solo traveler, please do not be hesitant sa pakipag-connect sa ibang tao, you know.
I think that's the most important thing kasi people think, well, others are saying that life is really traveling solo, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you're really traveling alone. It's in this solo traveling that we get to a chance to interact with other people. So, tawag dito, yung mga introvert, yung mga naging introvert ng pandemic, medyo let go ng konti, get to know other people para you have other friends from other places, di ba?
Yep, and actually, dun talaga sa courage zone, which is outside the comfort zone, kung saan talaga tayo natututo and mas nag-grow, diba? So, if that means you have to meet new people, that at the same time, you have to, you know, kailangan mong tanggalin yung hiya mo, diba?
Yes.
For you to grow, do it.
Yeah. Okay? Okay, ako, ang day, one word to describe last week, it's simple. It's almost uneventful yung nangyari sa akin last week, except last Friday, kasi I went to the mall with my mom. Tapos we were able to buy things na parang less than 200 pesos, and you know the koripot side of me is so happy. So ibig sabihin meron pa mabibili sa 200 pesos. So I'm in that mall, so I'm parang hi, ganun nga, oo nga. So those are simple joys na until now I still smile every time I remember that, because those are surprises in life na parang ine-expect mo, okay, sige, babayaran mo naman siya, bado. But then, if they tell you by the counter na, ma'am, this is my discount pa, ganon. So, it gives a smile on your face. Of course, nakakatipid ka. Okay. And of course, the surprise part na, ha, talaga ba? Yung mga ganon.
Paningulat. Ganon.
Talaga ginawa. Ayoko. Magbasa tayo ng comment. Magbasa tayo. Okay, binigyan tayo ng tatlong heart ni Ginesti Adroneda. I don't know, can you do this? I don't know. Yeah, thank you so much. Sabi ni JC Legazpi, hi po. Hello. Jonelle said, ako in love and dreamers. Oh. Baka pwede ma-explain mo, Jonelle. Babasahin namin ko. Joke lang. Jomar Pabilion is watching from 60 Chicago Street, Cubao. That's where the
Yeah, Jaan po, naka-base yung SBR TV, yes. Shepherd's Voice. Yep.
Yes, hi. What else? What
Ace.
Else, Kian?
One word to describe is grateful, despite of the challenges in our daily lives. Yun, medyo maraming challenges last week, but you always be grateful. Tama yan.
Ayan.
From Randy, we have a prayer request here, a prayer for us. Thank you so much for sharing a prayer for the rest of, you know, the viewers.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay, and we are waiting for your comments. Just let us know. And we'll read some of it later. But for now, we do have some announcements for you. Of course, we want to keep you updated for what's happening here at the Feast Bay Area and the Feast PICC AM. All right, and let's start with this. We have... other online shows aside from this live feast every Sunday. So we have live shows daily shows from Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So you can check this schedule on your screen, and you can watch these shows on our Facebook and YouTube accounts of the Feast PICC AM and other Feast Bay Area channels.
Yeah.
All right. And so for next...
Our next, we have ways to give. This, your generosity helps us to give to our Mercy Ministries. You may deposit your tithes via BDO, Unionbank, and we also have GCash and QR.ph. Thank you so much for the help that you're going to give to our ministries.
Right, and you just don't support the feast alone, but you are supporting a lot of Mercy Ministries. So thank you so much again for your generosity. And again, next week, we will still be here in PICC Plenary Hall.
Yes, punta kayo dito. Yep.
Wala pa naman kaming plano magpalit ng venue. So we'll be here for the, you know, for the time being. All Sundays of April, 10 a.m. for the English session, which you are watching right now.
Yes.
And the 1:30 p.m. session for the Taglish with Brother Alvin Barcelona.
Yes, all there's right. A seat for you here. We're waiting for you and you are welcome.
Correct. Marami pang upuan dito. Inihintay ka na lang namin.
Yes.
All right. And if you are watching here on site, we do have some formation programs for you and for your family. And one of each is a confession, the Sacrament of Confession, which is actually available every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., which is just outside of the plenary hall at the second floor. So... you know, if you are feeling, if you want to speak to the Lord, you know, more, diba? Mas intimate, let us know. And you can join us via confession as well.
Yan.
What and for...
Ayan. Yep. Oh, you first timers. Sabi natin kanina, hello sa inyo.
Yep.
At please stay tuned to this one. We have an after feast Zoomustahan. Join us via Zoom. Our servants are going to welcome you. Just check the meeting ID and the password so that we can welcome you formally to our community.
Awesome. All right. And a few more announcements here. Again, for another formation program as well. For our kids, for our young ones, for our ages 4 to 6 years old, we have an awesome kids ministry available every after the Holy Mass celebration here at the Peace PICC.
Yes.
Okay, and right.
Oy, ito mabigat to. Bigatin to. So, this is a concert. It's called Awit ng Panahon Noon at Ngayon. It's a musical concert. It's happening on April 21 at the New Frontier Theater. That's Sunday at 7 p.m. Our classic talented OPM artists are going to be here, like Gino Padilla, Haji Alejandro, Rachel Alejandro, of course, Chris Lawrence, at marami pang iba. This is for the benefit of the Anuim Lay Missions Foundation. Proceeds will go there. So if you'd like to have fun, enjoy music, and at the same time be able to help Anuim, go to ticketnet.com.ph. Tickets are available there.
Awesome. All right. So we are inviting you to join that concert. It would be so much fun.
Yes.
All right. And for our married couples, we do have the Lux Batch 31. This is a couples weekend getaway. This is happening on April 26 and 27 at St. Camillus Loyola Heights, Quezon City. So if you are interested to join this formation for couples, married couples, please scan the QR code or visit the link bit.ly/LUX31registration. Or you can contact the phone numbers on the screen.
Yes, punta kayo dyan para mas maging matibay ang inyong pagsasamahan as married couples.
Tama.
That's it.
All right. And if you are interested to bring the feast experience to your office, to your home, or sa neighborhood nyo, why don't you sign up as a Feast Light Planter? So you can scan a QR code which is flash on the screen, or you can join, or you can visit the Feast Light table outside. So ano ba tong Feast Light? So ito yung we played the talks of Brother Bro, Brother Odi sa inyong mga tahanan, sa inyong office, ganyan, sa inyong mga barkadahan, ganyan-ganyan. And talk about it after, di ba?
Yes.
Para you can have a daily reflection with your friends and family then, di ba? Alright. So again, scan the QR code if you are interested to join. Alright. And
And yes, please join us here in the kitchen. We're serving here with smiles on our hearts, and we hope that you get to experience that one. So we hope you could serve with us. Just scan the QR code, and let's have some fun serving our community.
Yep, we have different ministries to choose from. We are from the production ministry, but we also have other ministries such as worship, liturgy, and first timers, and even media. So if you are interested, just scan a QR code.
All right, that's it. I think that's about it for one more for our deaf brothers and sisters. If you want to communicate with them and to serve them here at the Feast Deaf Ministry, we have learning sessions on April 28 and May 12 for the Deaf Awareness and Filipino Sign Language learning sessions. Bumilis yung pagsasabi ko, no? Dito sa PICC, scan the QR code para lahat tayo palagi tayong gumaganto.
Yeah. I wanna learn as well. You know, it's really nice to connect with them, diba?
Yeah.
You know, using the sign languages. I wanna learn, so pupunta ko dyan for sure. All right, and we have a few more minutes left before we officially start our session. So if you are on the road, ingat po, papunta, and we are super waiting for you. So we still have seats for you. But for now, if you are at home, you still have time to make some preparations before we start the Holy Mass. So if you need to grab your Bible, rosary, or light up a candles, or kailangan mo munang kumain, or mag-toothbrush, ganyan-ganyan, do it. And gather your family and watch the feast together. And it, for sure, marami kayong matutunan for today's video.
Yeah, for today's video.
Okay.
And here at the PICC, well, thank you so much for joining us. Mass is coming up, and then there's worship and the talk of our builders. Thank you so much for joining us. It's the third Sunday of Easter.
Mm-hmm.
Still happy because this is 50 days of happiness. So, yeah, thank you so much for joining us. This is Anne, your live engager, together with
Kian. My name is Kian, and have a blessed Sunday, everyone.
Thank you.
Using the Novena to God's Love in the Feast app is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Open your Feast app. At the footer below, press Pray. On the header bar, swipe left and press Community Prayers. Click on Novena to God's Love. You will see the audio version. To write your dreams, click the down arrow button on the top of the screen. The text version of the Novena will now appear. Then, click the notes icon on the bottom of the screen. Click Write Dreams. You can now write your 7 dreams. Don't forget to pray for it! The Feast app.
Feed your faith.
What used to be just something from the scriptures became alive through the love of the people around us.
Pero bakit ngayon parang ang labo lahat, hindi ko maintindihan kung ano gusto kong gawin.
I'm still at peace. God was still gracious to the relationship that I have.
Pero hindi ko magawang mag-respond dun sa sinasabi nila na mabuti ang Diyos, may plano ang Diyos.
Pero nung na-realize ko naman na hindi lang pala trabaho ang para mabuhay ang tao, kailangan mo rin palang magpasalamat. Magpasalamat ka dahil kung anong meron ka ngayon.
Bakit hindi pa kami buo? Bakit nasira to? Ano bang nangyari?
Sinabi ko sa kanila, paanin ba ni Lord itong 10 pesos natin, 5 pesos natin? Wala, pero what will God do in our hearts if give it?
Nindot kaya itong pagtulunan nga Katoliko, daghan kita sa ginoo pa ni Brother Alvin, murabag buffet. Nga daghan kita choice ng para maluwas. Daghan kita pamagi, daghan kita prayer warrior.
I think mas maraming tao pa yung may kailangan ng ganitong hope na hindi natatapos ang buhay sa mga masasamang nangyayari sa atin. May plano pa sa atin si Lord.
Sanctuary where bonds are formed, where hearts find comfort, a journey that goes beyond what is, touching every facet of life. It's more than a gathering. It's a harmony of shared experiences. A foundation of hope.
A vibrant mosaic of life's joy and challenges. A space for support and a sense of belonging.
A place where our faith deepens and our spirits nourished. Let's journey together. Let's start now. You are home. You are welcome. You are loved.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand for the prayer to Saint Michael the Archangel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for a while. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to our Eucharistic celebration this third Sunday of Easter. In today's Gospel, the risen Christ appears to the two of his disciples, proving to them that he is truly alive. Then he gives them the mission to witness to what God has done to his people through his death and resurrection. In the risen Savior, God reconciles the whole world to himself. We share this mission of the apostles. Through our confident faith, lively hope, and life-giving love, we witness to people around us that Jesus is truly alive and is present in our day-to-day life. Our priest presider for this Eucharistic celebration is Reverend Father Albert Garong, SSP. Let us all rise to greet our celebrant as we begin our celebration.
Come, resound, praise the heavens, for he is good. Come, rejoice, and be glad, for he has made his day.
Listen, I've got some news from the Lord, straight from his word. Saying,
you don't have to be afraid, you don't have to hesitate, for his love is here to stay.
Not even death can stop him now, no more chains to hold you down, for he has overcome. Oh, come, resound.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
To God in the heart.
praise you, we bless you, we adore, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. In the name of the apostles, Peter declares to the crowd that the ministry and the death of Jesus were according to God's plan of salvation. Because Jesus was obedient to the Father, God raised him up and made him the source of our salvation. The first reading.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one, and the Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep, for you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling.
Lord, let your face shine on us. John instills confidence in the hearts of sinners. God the Father is ready to forgive us because in the risen Christ, we have a powerful intercessor before God's throne. The second reading.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel. Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. That it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses to these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Easter to all of you. I remember one time when I was still a seminarian. So, it's like college days for me, mga 3 years ago. The joke lang. Medyo matagal na, mga early 2000s, no? We went out and, you know, for seminarians, it's very rare to be able to go out. Like, maybe once a month, twice a month. Maswerte na kami sa twice a month. And then, one time, there was a group of us that said, "Uy, it's our free time. We want to check a place out kasi there's this new place, this new fast food kainan na was offering something that at that time was very innovative and unheard of. It's called Only Rice." Ayun yung sa simbahan, there's a saying, there's an age-old nugget of wisdom that people in the know very well. And it's that your kitchen upside down. But there he was, there were around 12 of us. We went out, we looked for the nearest branch of that fast food. Meron sa Tagaytay, so we went there. Silang yung seminary. And then we ate, no? And sabi, "Totoo kaya? Is it really Only?" And so we ordered, there's a big table for us. And we kept signaling to the server, "Can you... more rice, please. Rice again, please." You know, seminarians to, yung first 3 cups, toyo at saka chicken oil pa lang yun, guys. Wala pa, di pa natitinag yung manok. Buo pa siya, you know. And then, after so many times, sabi namin talaga, "I wonder when they will stop us. Because this is getting ridiculous." No, na-challenge kami. So, chinallenge din namin sila. Only rice, ah. And then finally, we saw the supervisor talking to the servers, and we were wondering, ito na. I think they have reached the point of sobra na, so they will make an excuse. And then the server exits, enters the kitchen, and he comes out with the rice cooker. Freshly cooked rice. And he goes to our table and puts it there, just for us. And then, the best part, he says, "Marami pa po yan." We lost that gamble. Talo kami. But it was such a beautiful thing. Sabi, totoo nga. This is the real deal, no? Why am I saying this to you? Not to show why I am right now. Hindi po yun, no? This is not the story of my life. Actually, mas malaki ako noon, no? But it's because, you know, sometimes, you know, when you are met with such a bold, huge gift, it's so hard to receive it, right? There's a part of us that always meets generosity, especially when it's so much with doubt. Parang, totoo ba to? And it usually serves us well. When you receive a text that says, "Congratulations, you won the raffle, just click this link." Of course you know, I hope you know, that that's not true. That's your instinct kicking in and serving you well. Most of the time, that's okay. But there is one thing, one time that we shouldn't do it. And it is with the Lord. And here in the gospel, we see that very well. The disciples are already getting the news of Jesus alive again. And there were eyewitnesses already telling them, "He's alive, he's alive." But it just doesn't pierce to them. It doesn't break through that doubt na talaga ba? Totoo ba? Can something so good really happen to us? We all know this feeling, right? Lahat naman tayo merong doubts. And today, I'd like to offer, you know, how Christ meets our doubts in the way he met the doubts of the apostles. And the first thing out of the gate that Jesus says to them is what? Peace. Peace be with you. That's meaningful because the first fear that the apostles had was, if he is truly alive, we're doomed because we abandoned this man. Our friend, we left him in this most difficult moment of his life. We were not there. And patay tayong lahat. But Christ sees their fear, and the first thing he tells them is, peace. Relax. I know what you did, but relax. I come in peace. Many of you, many Catholics, are so afraid of confession because you feel that you will be met by wrath and judgment. But the Lord will always say, peace. Because God's peace is always bigger than our sins. There is no contest. And every time someone comes to him, the response is always, peace. Relax. And to stress the point more, Jesus always combines the peace message with what? He shows his wounds to them and tells them, look. Look how you wounded me. Look how you destroyed my body. This peace, it's not cheap. I know, and I suffered through your sins. But nevertheless, what I say to you, the first thing is peace. It's Easter, my dear brothers and sisters. I hope before anything else we can accept that God only wants to make peace. Ang goal lang niya, magkaayos kayo. Tayong lahat. Wala siyang ibang agenda sa atin. Second, after peace comes hope. Hope in the sense that what Jesus does with the apostles is to explain to them scripture. Nakatuwa. Bakit kaya? His design is to tell them, look, look, look. Look at what has been written thousands of years ago. Look at what has been prophesied. All of this, all that happened, none of it is accident, you know? The crucifixion is not, you know, one last gamble, you know, a last resort for God to save us. No. Every single thing that happened that scared you so much has always been in God's plans. What is the source of our hope, my dear brothers and sisters? The source of our hope is simply that whatever is happening to you right now, whatever you've been through, no matter how horrible that is, all of it is within God's power and within God's wisdom. He didn't plan it in a sense that he made it happen to you. That's not true. We all use our free will. We're all either because of your free will or the free will of others who victimize you. But nevertheless, all of that is in God's hands. Always. None of it can slip out. And because it's in God's hands, it can always be meaningful, purposeful, and can be used to help you and heal you and make you grow. That is our hope. Not that our life is painless. Sometimes we complain to God, no, Lord, ang daya mo. Nagsisimba naman ako, bakit mo ako binigyan ng sakit? When did God ever promise that? What He promised is that none of it will go to waste if you put it in my hands. And it will always be meaningful. That is our superpower as Christians. Claim it. The world looks at pain and wants to destroy it because they think that pain is the end. When you suffer, you lose. Our superpower says no. Suffering can be an instrument for our growth, for our holiness. It is transformed in the same way that a lifeless body entered the tomb and something, the source of life, came out of that. You know? Peace, hope. Finally, God meets our doubts with love. Love in its purest form, which is presence. God, Jesus, the person himself, came to them. And more importantly, they recognized Jesus in acts of eating. Bakit kaya? They recognized Jesus when he broke the bread. There's so much into that about how so much of our relationships is formed over food. How when you invite a person to go to coffee, it's not really about the beverage. You're there to deepen relationships. But most importantly, because God's presence will continue to be with us in the form of broken bread. And that is the Eucharist. I will never stop saying this because this is the hardcore truth of our faith. The Eucharist Mass is everything because here you meet God in the flesh, real presence. And then at the end of it, you actually get to partake in that presence. Everything that we do, all our faith practices, is based on and leads towards meeting the person of Jesus Christ, especially in the Eucharist, because this is where his real presence is found. My dear brothers and sisters, yes, we have doubts. Yes, we have weaknesses. But see how God meets all of it with peace, with hope, with love. And whenever you feel any sort of doubt lingering in your heart, remember what that server told us. Marami pa yan. Hindi yan mauubos. Huwag kayong matakot. Ang pag-ibig, ang pag-asa, ang kapayapaan ng Diyos, hindi mauubos, sapat para sa ating lahat. Amen. We rise to profess our faith. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
In the breaking of the bread, Christ Jesus makes himself known to us as our life and resurrection. He sends us to be witnesses to his name. Through him, we present our petitions to the Father and we pray, Lord, listen to your people.
Lord, listen to your people.
May the church be a beacon of light, helping people who are in darkness to come to know your Son as the way, the truth, and the life. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May all leaders, by governing with fidelity those entrusted to their care, build nations in peace, brotherhood, and respect for human dignity. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May all consecrated men and women proclaim your resurrection through their lives, their prayer, and their service to others. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May you bless our labor, that it may sustain our life on earth and enhance our human dignity, ease our burden, make our faith strong, and inspire us to put our trust in you. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May you bless our relatives and friends, give them constant encouragement, and guide them throughout their lives. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May all of us gathered here, that the word of God and our Eucharistic communion be our sustenance as we face the day-to-day trials and challenges and what the future holds. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May those who have died, who had participated in the Eucharistic banquet here on earth, now enjoy the heavenly banquet in heaven. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
For the intentions of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, this month of April, that the dignity and immense value of women be recognized in every culture, and for the end of discrimination that they experience in different parts of the world, we pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
We bow down as we pray for our personal intentions and all intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
God, our Father, you restored us to yourself through the resurrection of Christ, your Son. Hear the prayers of your people and strengthen us in giving witness to our Easter faith. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the Eucharist.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift him up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, we pray with the words that Jesus himself taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand. For orderly communion, please be seated and wait for the ushers to guide you. Thank you.
single breath you're there, in every single step you're the lamp unto my feet, and I don't have to worry about a single thing, 'cause being here with you is everything. You see right through the mess in me. You cleanse me from my shame, wash me off my sin and guilt. You're the way, the truth, the life to eternity. In you I am restored, renewed, complete. I will worship you and surrender. You have changed my life forever. For here with you I found the answer that you. No other. You're my living water. You just come and you have come. And you I am made you. You have found my heart and you have only just begun. So work upon my heart, what should be done. I will worship you and surrender. You have changed my life forever. For here my soul. Now if I may know,
You have changed my life forever. Here with you I found the answer that you
Let's have a moment of silence to cherish the presence of Jesus in our hearts. Please rise.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We will now call on the lectors and commentators who are renewing their commitment to serve for another year in the liturgical ministry of the Light of Jesus family, particularly in the Feast Bay area.
My brothers and sisters, helpers in this service, you have been called and now to be commissioned again for another year as liturgical ministers. I urge you to be models of Catholic living in the manner you worship, talk, serve, and love, and the way you live. Strive to be holy by means of a true love of the liturgy, the sacrament of love and unity. Dear lectors and commentators, you are not just readers, but proclaimers of the Word of God. To speak in the name of God, to deliver His message of love, and to express His thoughts, His will, and concern. Only with strong prayer life and sacramental life can you succeed in the ministry which is based on an intimate partnership with God and generous commitment to Christ. Lectors and commentators, please answer the following questions truthfully. Are you resolved to undertake once more the office of lectors and commentators, the duty and responsibility to proclaim the Word of God in the Holy Eucharist celebrated in the Feast Bay area?
Yes, Father, I am.
Are you resolved to serve once more with the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of humility, gratitude, generosity, love, and service, not seeking your own pleasure, convenience, and honor, but the glory of God and the building up of the body of Christ, the Church?
Yes, Father, I am.
My brothers and sisters, let us pray with confidence to the Father. Let us ask Him to send His grace on our brothers and sisters who have been recommissioned as lectors and commentators. Kindly bow your heads, lectors and commentators. Everlasting God, when Jesus read in the synagogue at Nazareth, He proclaimed the good news of salvation for which He would give up His life. Bless these proclaimers. As they proclaim your words of life, strengthen their faith that they may read with conviction and boldness and put into practice what they read. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Can we give our lectors and commentators a round of applause? Thank you for your service. And we hope that they will grow. I mean, not them, but their numbers will grow. So whoever is interested, kindly also apply.
Let us all thank Reverend Father Albert Garong for celebrating the Holy Eucharist with us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of His only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you gladness by His blessing.
Amen.
And may He, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with Him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go in the peace of and love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Before you sit down, can you just grab somebody's arms, hands, shoulders, and even give them that big hug and just tell them, welcome to your family. Welcome to your family. This is your family. This is your little spiritual community. Amen. So good. So good. Please be seated, everybody. I'd like to greet 100 students from St. Catherine of Siena from Bataan. Could you all stand up? Just want to say thank you for coming. Beautiful young people. Love it. Love it. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Please be seated. Aldrin, thank you for bringing them over. So good. Thank you, Aldrin. Amen. While you prepare your love offering, Audie assigned me to just encourage you to give. And I decided I'm going to give you an old man's parlor trick. Is that okay? I'm going to entertain you while you prepare your love offering. Not very entertaining, but never mind. For young people, what I'm going to do right now, sweetheart, can you come here? And no, you don't have to say anything. You just have to hold the microphone for me. But you see, semi-old people like me, one of the things that we lose is balance. We lose our balance so much. And can you hold this, sweetheart? And then, so the thing that happens is that parang hindi bagay yung ano yung tunog, kasi entertainment. So, just kidding. Hindi naman entertainment. No, this is not entertainment. This is actually, there are some people who say that this is a life-saving skill. It will save your life because old people, they lose their balance and then they fall. And when they fall, you will break a bone. And when you break a bone, what happens is that's when you deteriorate. Have you heard of this? And so I learned about it and I said, oh my gosh, it's true. I'm losing my balance. And so what I did was I tried to stand on one foot and then I said, ang hirap. You know, I'd actually lose my balance. Young people, you're laughing at me right now. You know, I'm dali-dali niyan. Yes, it's true. When I was young, I probably had easy. So if there are volunteers here who want to imitate me, I'm going to do something and you just follow me. Especially those in the front row. You can actually stand up. Kasi may space kayo eh. May space kayo. Or you're beside a corridor or a row or a what do you call it? An aisle. Not you. Anyone older, anyone that's as old as me or older, don't do it. Okay? This is, okay. Those of you at home, don't do this at home if you're my age or older. Okay? So what you do is this. Okay. First thing you do is remove your shoes. And then remove your socks. So, yung mga nagbo-volunteer, medyo mangangamoy ng yung PICC, pero for the sake of science. Okay. So, this is what you do. You stand on one leg, and then you try to pick up your sock. And then you try to wear it. And then you get your shoe. And then you remove your... your laces. And then... you wear your shoe. And then you tie it.
Upo ka na lang daw, sabi. You have to explain what you're doing.
So, there. Okay. Okay, next.
Mga ilang buwan mo to pinag-practice.
Okay, this is hard. Sometimes one side is harder than the others.
Of course, you're stronger yeah. on one side.
Okay. And then.
Oh,
This is hard. Okay. Thank you. 3 months ago, it's amazing what we do to exhort people to give. But 3 months ago, I would fall about 10 to 12 times doing that. 3 months ago. But I thought to myself, I put on my shoes every day. So I said, why don't I try doing it every single day, every single day, every single day. And 3 months later, I'm so much better, so much better. And the key is this. Can you tap somebody in the arm and say, be consistent? If you want changes in your life, just be consistent in anything. Whether you say to yourself, you know, I lack water, or I lack sleep in my health, or I need to exercise. There are people who go to the feast once a month. They go to the feast when they feel like it, when it fits their schedule. They go to the feast when it's not raining, whenever it rains. Ay, wag na lang. They go to the feast when they feel like going to the feast. Kailangan ko ng pumunta. Bakit? Ang tagal-tagal na. I feel spiritually dry. You know, they go to the feast based on feelings and convenience. I want you to know, if you're not consistent, you're delaying the process of your strength. I became stronger in my muscles simply by just doing something every single day, less than 60 seconds. Like every day, less than 60 seconds, putting on my shoes and my socks, using one leg. And I got stronger just little by little by little. And this is my point. I want you to make a commitment to go to the feast, whether you like going or not, whether you feel going or not, whether it rains or not, whether there's traffic or none, whether it's difficult to park in PICC. I mean, just say, it's non-negotiable. I'm going to be consistent. I'm going to feed my spirit. I'm going to nourish my soul. I'm going to strengthen my relationship with God. I'm going to be with my brothers and sisters in community. I'm going to be consistent. And when you're consistent, here's what's going to happen. You're going to grow. You're going to be stronger. You're going to be better. You're going to be blessed more because you are in the place of blessings. Do you understand what I'm saying? Did you hear what I'm saying? You are in the place of miracles. You are nearer. You are more proximate to the God who blesses. And when you open up yourself every Sunday to the presence of God. So tell somebody beside you, be consistent. Just make a decision every week, non-negotiable. And by the way, so this morning I had prayer room. Prayer room is an online thing that I do in TikTok and in Facebook, and it's live. And then hundreds of people join me live, and then thousands catch up through the replay. This morning was very interesting. I had two phones in front of me, TikTok and Facebook, and I said, hi guys, happy Sunday, you know, join me at the feast, and there's a feast near you. And the people started messaging, what is the feast? They didn't know what the feast is. And I said, oh, it's a spiritual gathering, it's a family. My friends, you've got office mates and classmates and friends who don't even know what the feast is. And you need to talk to them and tell them to come. And then, eto na. I love this part. Brother Bo, I'm from Iloilo. May feast ba dito? Yes, there is. Please search in Facebook, Feast Iloilo. Brother Bo, where's the feast in Cebu? Another person asked. Oh, Ayala Malls. You know, again, search in Facebook, feast. And then somebody said, Brother Bo, I'm a feaster in CDO. Another said, Brother Bo, I'm a feaster in Feast Dasma. And Brother Bo, I loved it. And there was somebody who asked, Brother Bo, san yung feast at Dagupan? Oh, there's a feast in Dagupan. It's a small one, but it's vibrant and it's there. My friends, there's a feast in Bataan. There is. You know, there are feasts in hundreds of cities in 26 countries. And I'm telling you, it's worth it. It's worth it. When you are consistent, mahihirapan ka. Of course. Every day, I put on my shoe and my sock. With one leg, standing on one leg, ang hirap. Yes or no? Ba't ko pinapahirapan ang sarili ko? In the same way, when you start making a commitment to be at the feast
every week.
Mahirap. Mahirap yan.
Umuulan, pupunta ka.
Mahirap yan.
Walang parking, pupunta ka pa rin.
But it's a good thing. And it will strengthen you. And it will bless your life.
I want you to support the feast. I want you to give whatever the Lord wants to you to give. And make a decision. Make it a habit. Let me end with this verse. Let's all stand. The Bible says, do not give up the habit of meeting together. Do not give up the habit. And I'm going to say this. I'm going to appropriate that verse for you. Do not give up the habit of being here every week or whatever feast you belong to. Do not give up the habit of giving and supporting the move that God is doing in this world. My dear friends, can I say this? The feast is not perfect. And the people around you, they're not perfect. In fact, we're all a bunch of weird, strange, horrible people. We've got sins and we've got weaknesses. So please be careful. You know, pag may communion, you see it being flashed on the screen. Take care of your belongings. You know, because we're a bunch of struggling sinners here. You know, don't be too safe. You know, like I'm with saints. No, you're with a bunch of very, very imperfect people who are struggling, who fail. But you know what? We're doing it together. We're reaching out to the Lord every week and we're saying, Lord God, come. The perfect people, they don't come here. But because we're imperfect, we need God. Everybody say, I need God. Everybody say, I need God every day. Every week. Tell somebody beside you, see you at the feast every week. Emphasize, underline every week. Consistency. Consistency. Raise up your envelope and your love offering and just say this prayer with me. Jesus, I thank you that you are giving me this opportunity to give to a movement, to a community that is changing thousands of people all over the world. And I thank you that you are giving me the gift of consistency, of faithfulness, to be here in your spiritual family every week. In Jesus' name, amen. Give to the Lord, everybody. Love the Lord.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Here are today's announcements. Take a moment today for cleansing and renewal. The Sacrament of Confession is available today from 11 a.m. until 3 p.m. You may ask any of our ushers to guide you. Parents, want your kids to have a feast experience that's made just for them? Our Awesome Kids Ministry is now open for the duration of our morning session at the Banquet Hall 3 here in PICC. Once again, that's at Banquet Hall 3. The Awesome Kids Ministry starts after the 10 a.m. and 1:30 p.m. masses. Just approach any of our ushers to guide you and your little ones. Do you miss the feast during the week? Continue nourishing your mind, heart, and soul through our online weekly programs via our Feast Bay Area Facebook page. Check out our lineup and connect with your feast family throughout the week. See you online! Turn to the person beside you and ask them, are you a disciple maker? If you want to share the feast experience with your home, office, or neighborhood, then it's time to be a Feast Light planter. For more details, scan the QR code or visit the Feast Light table at the lobby. Next Sunday, April 21, we will still be here at the PICC Plenary Hall for the 10 a.m. and 1:30 p.m. sessions. Please observe PICC's dress code and make sure to follow us on social media for more updates. Enjoy great music while supporting a worthy cause. we're inviting everyone to watch Awit ng Panahon Noon at Ngayon musical concert on April 21 at the New Frontier Theater. Remember the good times with timeless OPM songs and a heartwarming story that reflects a nostalgic kind of love, beauty, and perspective on our changing times, along with spectacular visual effects. A huge portion of the proceeds from the concert will benefit the Anawim Lay Missions Foundation, our home for the abandoned elderly. This musical concert will feature various talented local artists like Haji Alejandro, Rachel Alejandro, Gino Padilla, and more. Get your tickets now at www.ticketnet.com.ph. Let's hear our married couples in the house. Take your partner's hand and tell them, have an extra special summer with me. We're all inviting married couples to join us in Lux, a couples weekend getaway batch 31, happening on April 26 to 27. Discover new things about each other, find new ways to celebrate your love, and journey together with Jesus. Register via the link or QR code on screen, or visit the couples ministry table at the lobby for more details. Have you ever wanted to connect with even more people in our community? Learn how to interact with the deaf and also serve in our Feast Deaf Ministry through the Deaf Awareness and Filipino Sign Language Learning Session. This is open to Feast servants and attendees with two training date options. Scan the QR code or visit the link on screen to register. Check out your Feast Bulletin for more information and make sure to follow the Feast PICC AM on social media. And now, brothers and sisters, let's all watch this.
What seems to be the end can be a new beginning. A season that invites us out from the shadows and into the light, where we explore the dimensions of love, identity, fulfillment, and eternity. A season that echoes the triumph from the grave and what it truly means to be
join our hearts. Let us worship Jesus today. Our loving, our caring, our giving, our merciful God. And let us declare His goodness as we sing praises to Him today. Are we ready? Let's put our hands together. Come on. Present and future, Let us lift up our hallelujahs to Jesus today as loud as we can, for we sing to a living God. Amen. With all I am and all I have, I sing to you for all you've done. With everything I lift my
deeper in worship. May I invite you to ask yourself this question: who am I? Who am I beyond my name? Who am I beyond my past, my future? Who am I beyond my titles, my achievements, my failures, my regrets? It's a simple question, but it's so profound. But in today's gospel, we heard two disciples were still so confused while they were breaking bread with Jesus. In Luke 24, verse 39, Jesus said, "Touch me and see for yourself." Today, brothers and sisters, God is inviting us. God is telling us. God is telling you, touch me and see for yourself. Who am I? I am yours, God. And so today, as we worship, we want to touch God and see for ourselves who we truly are. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know where you've been, or no matter how far you think away you are from God. But what I do know is who we are. We are His. Can I invite you? If you can close your eyes, we're gonna touch God through our worship today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Father, silence the thoughts in my mind and open my heart to your presence. We connect to your spirit at the deepest level as one community, here in this place or even online. For we are yours. Let's worship God.
I'm greeted to dust, I shall fall, but you won't. You're greater than my failures and all of my faults.
control, you are stronger than ever before. You are higher, you're Lord above all. You are greater in my weakness. You still call me yours.
God, you have seen me in my darkest days. You chose. Out in your love that I'm saved by your grace. You are God. You're my God. God, you are sovereign. When I lose control, you are stronger. Never fall, you are higher. You're Lord above all, you are greater. In my weakness, you still call me yours.
Let's declare this to Jesus.
All of my hopes, all of my dreams, all of it's yours. All of it's yours. All of my victories, all of my plans, all of it's yours. All of it's yours. Everybody sing. All of my hopes, all of my dreams, all of it's yours. All of it's yours. All of my victories, all of my plans, all of it's yours.
Jesus, you are touching me right now. In fact, right this moment, here in this sacred space, I allow you to come and embrace me. Come, put your arms around me. Jesus, come. I am receiving your touch right now. I'm receiving your embrace. Right now, thank you, Jesus. And in this embrace, I just bask in your love and I immerse myself in how much you love me. Jesus, thank you. Thank you for making me yours, that I belong to you. And I declare it to the universe. I declare it to everyone. I declare it to myself. I do not belong to the world. I do not belong to my past. I do not belong even to myself. I belong to you, Jesus. 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 I belong to the Lord. Hallelujah.
My dreams, all of it is yours. All of it.
Amen. Give the Lord a big hand. Love Him. Love Him. You belong to God. You belong to God. Oh, yes. If you can put your arms around somebody and announce to that person, you belong to God. You belong to God. You belong to God. So good. So good. So good. Are you blessed, everybody? Wave at me if you're blessed. Are you blessed? Everybody say, I'm blessed. And then tell somebody beside you, you look beautiful today. You belong to God and you look beautiful. You look wonderful. Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to, if you can do this, if we're going to say our favorite prayer, let's just say it with all conviction. Today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself so I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I'm God's beloved, I'm God's servant, I'm God's powerful champion, and because I am blessing the world in Jesus' name, amen. And Father God, we pray that your word be spoken loud and clear, and we pray for the anointing, as you have always done, anointing our preacher and our leader, Audie Villaraza, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let's give a big hand to Audie. Hallelujah.
If I could ask you to remain standing for a few moments as we break open the word of God. We are in this wonderful presence today. Everybody lift up your hands and let's sing together. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The scripture that I am going to read to you today, it's not new. Let me give you fair warning. You've heard this scripture time and time again. For some of you, you might have heard this being preached almost, five times a year, or maybe even more than that. It comes from the book of Genesis. And the reason why I'm choosing this piece of scripture, this passage, is it encourages me so much to know that some of you here who might be coming for the first time, you have no idea how God sees you and how God loves you. And this scripture will change all that. And I hope that you're ready to receive this. It comes from Genesis chapter 1, verse 27. Can we all read it together on the screen? Ready, set, go. So God created human beings in His own image. In the image of God, He created them. What image are we talking about? The image of? So in other words, according to this scripture, it's plain and simple. You look like God. Do you believe that? I didn't say that you are God. I just said that you look like God. Look at the person beside you. Just look at the person beside you. Don't laugh. That person represents the image of God. Amen? Now here's the reality. A lot of us, the biggest problem with many of us is that we don't usually always like ourselves, especially the way we look. I mean, if I ask you now, if there are some things that you can change about yourself, if you've got the time, the resources, and if you're young enough, you'd probably have something done, you know, to change some things. Medyo flat yung ilong ko, Brother Odi, gusto kong patangusin. Medyo singkit ang mata ko, gusto kong palakihin. Medyo nawawala na ako ng buhok, Brother Odi, gusto kong dagdagan. Yung eyebrow ko, Brother Odi, nag-hide and seek na. Gusto kong pakapalan. I mean, there are some things that we would want, you know, a little bit to change about ourselves. But here's the thing. That's how God made you. And you were created in the image and likeness of God. That's why, you know, for every person in here, even the people watching online, I truly believe this with all of my heart that you made the right decision to come to church today. Ask me why. Ask me a little bit louder, why? because the enemy doesn't want you here hearing from the preacher here on stage to tell you that God created you in His image and likeness, because He wants you to hate you for who you are. But God wants to tell you that you are perfectly, completely, and absolutely loved because He created you. So the enemy is shaking where he is because he knows that you're here in church and you're bound to get encouraged by this message today. He doesn't want you to do that. He wants you to hate yourself. Because when you start loving who you are and how God made you to be, you're liable to do great things for God. Do you believe that? Amen. Here's our big message for today. Are you ready for this? Can I ask you a favor? Simply because I can't reach out to everybody here, can you be the preacher to the person on your left and right? Is that okay? Can you preach to the person right now? Here it is. Copy Christ. Copy Christ. Amen. Copy Christ. Let's pray. Everybody bow down your heads. Father, this is your word. We thank you, Jesus, that you are here with us. And thank you, Father, that you created us in your image and likeness. But teach us how to love ourselves, how to appreciate ourselves the way that you appreciate us. Father, teach us that because Jesus is in us, we can do great things through His name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. One more time, everybody. Lift up your hands and give God the praise. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Give the Lord a big hand, everybody. We celebrate Him today. Amen. Amen. On your way down to your chair, touch your neighbor and say, get ready to be blessed. One more time, can you turn to someone and say, copy Christ. You know, when I was preparing for this message, I wanted to talk to you about this topic of copying. We are in talk two of our series called Race to Life, and we are trying to understand, you know, what are the evidences that you have been raised with Jesus, resurrected with Jesus. Last week, we talked about how Jesus gives you a new heart. When you get resurrected with Christ, He gives you a new kind of love, to love God and to love other people. The second talk is all about how Jesus gives you His new identity. The identity of Jesus gets planted in you. But I wanted to start this talk by laying a foundation of doing a simple activity. How many of you love music? Raise your hand. Thrill of different music. I'm going to play a song, and then I'll just do the intro. And if you know the song, don't tell me right away. I'm going to count to three, and then you can all tell the song, and we'll know who are, or more or less are the titos and titas in this room. So 8 seconds of the song. We got the DJ in the back. Can we play the song? Stop. How many of you know the song? Okay, on a count of three, shout me the song. One, two, three. Congratulations. You just completely revealed your age. But unfortunately, it's the wrong song. You want to hear the rest of the song? Can we play the rest of the song? So some of you are probably wondering, what in the world is that song? You see, okay, let me explain. A lot of you know Ice Ice Baby, the 90s hit song by Vanilla Ice. But what many of you don't know, if you're not really a music aficionado, if you don't grow up with a whole genre of music, is that, you know, the bass line of Ice Ice Baby was only copied from another hit song from the 1980s. That was written by Queen and David Bowie, entitled Under Pressure. But when the 90s song, and some of you knew that song, when the hit song Ice Ice Baby came along in the 1990s, it caught fire. Because it was the first time that we were hearing a rap version of that song. And eventually a lot of people, you know, they stuck with that song. So whenever you hear that bass intro, dung, 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 you automatically think that it's Ice Ice Baby. But many of you do not know is that Vanilla Ice was only a copycat from the original bass line of that version. You see, let me talk to you about the topic again of copying. Copying has been a practice in every culture. You copy original songs and you try to make it your own. We do that. You copy something that's so successful and you try to bank off on that. In fact, one of the things that we like to copy the most is how successful brands to bank off our idea on that. How many of you are familiar with the brand Under Armour? It's 98% cheaper. It's called Under Arms. Hindi po amoy pa yan. Amoy kilikili lang. Under Arms. And a lot of you know, of course, Jollibee, the fast food chain. But did you know that there's a copycat of Jollibee in Makati called the Jolly Jeep? You know that? You've eaten there? That little kiosk? They call that those kiosks Jolly Jeep. McDonald's. We all know McDonald's. A copycat of McDonald's is McDonald's. Alam niyo ba yan? Meron yan, McDonald's. Filipino version. Yung laro ang Robocat. Pag hindi mo kaya ma-afford yun, kasi mahal minsan, di ba? Pag pumunta kang Toy Kingdom, may mabibili kayo. Cheaper version. Ito, Robert Cup. May pangalan. Isa pa. Kilala nyo si Bart Simpson? There's a Tagalog version of that. Let's show. Baet Simpson. Grabe, no? Yung laro ang Transformers, ito, pakita ko sa inyo yung version na copycat. France Trommers. People have the craziest idea. Last one, Starbucks. There's another brand that copied off of this. It's called Sunbucks. Kasi nga naman, nasa galaxy pa rin naman yun, di ba? Star, sun. Copying is a practice in every culture. But you see, there's also a danger in copying. But let me say this, all right? Copying can be good. Copying can be good, especially if you copy the good stuff about you know, your family, for instance. You copy the way ate studies diligently. You copy how kuya respects the elders. You copy the good stuff. But there's a danger also in copying. I remember one stressful afternoon in our high school. I'd like to talk to all the grade 12 students. Can I hear from all the grade 12 students here in front? Can you give me a shout? Come on. Okay, Mia. All right, so this story is for you. One stressful afternoon, our high school science teacher walks in, and this is the nightmare of every student, is that the teacher will announce that there's a pop quiz. Am I right? And here's the worst part. You never prepared for it. So you could hear the grumble. 50% of the students in the room started grumbling. And usually you know the people who never prepare. You know, they usually prepare the day itself. And so she announces that there's a pop quiz. And so right then and there, you know, there was only one guy who had a smile from ear to ear. His name is Ernesto. That's not his real name, by the way, because I need to hide his name because of this story. And you'll find out in a moment. And so Ernesto was smiling because he's the smartest guy in our class. And he probably prepared for it. So when they were taking the class, you know, something crazy happened for the very first time. Ernesto, he usually sits in front of everyone. He kind of slides his paper on the side, you know, prodding people to copy his answers. And so we were all shocked. He's never done that before. And so, of course, naturally, we never hesitated for one bit. We copied, especially those who didn't study. Kasama na po ako dun. So that was before I was saved. So I was copying, you know, multiple choice. And by the end of the test, we were so proud, you know. We were going to pass this test. We thank Ernesto generously for that unbelievable act. And then finally, 2 days later, the same teacher comes in. She hands our test papers. And when she hands it to us, we were so excited. Pagdating nung test paper, baksak kami. We couldn't understand. Even Ernesto had that discouraged look. And finally, you know, the teacher reprimands us and tells us to prepare for class every time we come, that was the end of it until a week later. During recess, one of our friends, one of our classmates, asks Ernesto, "Can I borrow a pen?" To which he says, "Okay, go. Just go to my bag and get it." And when she opens the bag, lo and behold, there was the test paper of Ernesto sitting in front. She pulls it out and looks at it, 20 over 20. And she's like, "Huh? We copied the same exam. We have the same answers. Why in the world did he pass?" And then as she continued to examine it, she noticed that each answer had an erasure. Pinakopya kami, pero mali. Now, what are the lessons of this story? First lesson, ask me what? Mag-aral ka. Obviously, study hard. You know, I'm talking to the students. But here's the second lesson. Be careful what you copy. There's some things in this world that you think are good that you copy, but you don't know that what you're copying, here's the first danger, you're copying a copy from a copy. Let me show you another prop that I brought. Many of you will probably ask what this is, but if you know what this is, what I'm holding in my hand, can you please raise your hand? I'm losing 90% of the room. Do you know what this is? Okay, for those who are not raising their hands, this is what you call a cassette tape. Can you say that with me? Cassette tape. What does this do? This plays music. Okay? It plays music. Huh? How? I asked my son the other day, and I handed it to him. I said, "Ethan, what do you think this is?" He said to me, he was toying around with it. He says, "Dad, is this a toy car?" And I'm like, "Why do you say it's a toy car?" "Because it has two wheels in the middle." This plays music. Before they invented Spotify and YouTube and all these music apps, this is how we listen to music. You know, we would play this. And you know what I realized, parents, raise your hand. You know what I realized when I brought this out? A lot of us, we complain how the kids are so impatient nowadays. You know what? Why the reason they're so impatient? It's because they didn't grow up the way that we did. Everything is handed to them easy today. I mean, when you had to listen to music before, in order for you to rewind this, you needed a rewinding tape. If you had no rewinding tape, you could use a pencil or a ballpen, right? And that would take around 30 minutes to do. But kids nowadays, if you could just listen to music, they just pop on Spotify or YouTube. If people wanted movies, you know, you would just turn on Netflix or Disney Plus. Back in the day, you needed, you know, dial-up, you needed cable and all these things. That's why don't blame your children for being impatient. It's because the world has been given to them in the back of their pocket. They've got the internet on their phone. But anyway, back to the cassette tape, all right? Before the advent of Spotify and all these other technologies, what's funny about the cassette tape is that when you're young, you're not able to buy the original tape because it's so expensive. And then I see Louis nodding and the people here in front. Because they're so expensive. But if you didn't have the budget and the resources to buy the original tape, what would you do? You would buy a blank tape. A blank cassette tape. Because this tape, you could record over and over on this tape. You understand? But here's the thing. If you don't have access to the original tape, you could only resort to a copy of the original tape and you record that copy. Have you ever done that? You would have the most blurred, incoherent recording ever. You understand what I'm trying to say? If you copy only from a copy of the copy, the loss of quality is evident in your copy. Another example is this. There was a time before Netflix when if you wanted to watch, you know, a screening of a movie and you wanted it in advance just at the same time as they're playing the movie on the theater, the only way that you can do that is if you buy the advanced copy of a VCD. You remember those VCDs? And there were those VCDs that they used to sell in the streets that were so advanced, but there was a catch. The catch was when you're watching the movie, all of a sudden, somebody stands up. May nanonood. It was only the recording of somebody watching the movie. It's a copy from the copy. Now let me get biblical with you. Because this happened in the Old Testament, let me read it to you. Remember how we studied the Torah and how we talked about the journey from the wilderness to the promised land and how Moses was their leader during that time? Now there's a period in the book of Judges where the Israelites were now in the promised land, but then their leader wasn't Moses anymore. It was Joshua. And during the reign of Joshua, there was prosperity in the whole land. And they were obedient to the Lord until something happened. It says that in chapter 2 of Judges, verse 11, verse 10, after that generation died, another generation grew up who did not acknowledge the Lord or remember the mighty things He had done for Israel. The Israelites did evil in the Lord's sight and served the images of Baal. They abandoned the Lord, the God of their ancestors, who had brought them out of Egypt. In other words, let me explain this. The first settlers of the people in the promised land, they were obedient to the Lord because they were the ones who met Moses. You know, they were the ones who saw Moses. They received the law of God directly from Moses. But then as generations passed, the new believers now, they've never even seen Moses. They've never even met Moses. They've never even seen the tabernacle. They don't know about God. Why? Because the parents failed to teach it to them. So now this group of new believers, you know, there's a loss of quality as generations passed. The quality was dropping along with that generation. Now they did not know that what they were practicing was somebody else's golden calf. It was no longer God anymore. And you know, parents can make the same mistakes. Again, parents, can you raise your hand? So I know you're there. Listen to me. You can make the same mistakes with your children. What you do as parents, especially when they're young, can affect them when they eventually grow up. Did you know that whatever you prioritize as a family right now will be what they will copy eventually when they themselves become parents or when they grow up? So if you're like, you know, wag na tayo magsimba. Magmoling na lang tayo. Huwag ka na pumasok. Magburakay muna tayo. These are the values that you're teaching your children. And eventually, they'll pick up the same values and they're gonna transfer and copy that to their own children. So please, don't blame your children when they're teenagers that they don't know how to pray if you never taught them to pray when they were young. What you do right now and what you show to your children, they will copy eventually. The first danger, again, is that you copy from a copy. But there's a second danger when it comes to copying. Sometimes, when we're not conscious, we copy the injuries of people. In other words, we imitate injuries. Can I show you a quick video? Can we play a video? Here.
Let me say a warning. This video, you're not supposed to laugh. But the harder you hold it, the worse it gets. Yeah. Brace yourself. I did.
I will fight another sinner's threat in my entire life. I do believe that I will fight never ever sinner. My flesh took it up with something.
That video was called a Do Not Laugh Challenge. The topic is not supposed to be funny. I mean, we're talking about lung cancer, which is a very serious thing. But what's so funny about the video is that the kid is so innocent and just copies the voice of that woman. And that's what a lot of us unconsciously do, is that sometimes we're imitating injuries of other people. I gave a talk many months ago called You Need a New Roof about how sometimes our external factors, our parents, our siblings, our environment creates a ceiling for us and tells us that this is where you stop. And you're limited this way because this is the only way that your dad did this. This is the only way that your mom taught you how to do it. But some of these limitations are lies. They're not true. And we're very loyal to some of these lies. And that's the danger, that we imitate sometimes the injury of other people. And we got to be very conscious about it. But let me get very practical with a lot of you right now. I want to teach you four ways on how to reclaim your imago Dei, your image of God, that it's right there in you. And I want you to take notes if that's what you do. Here's number one. Embrace creativity and not just consumption. Embrace creativity and not only consumption. How many of you believe that God is a creator? Raise your hand. God is a creator. And as a creator, God is creative. Can you say that word, creative? You want evidence that God is creative? Tingnan mo yung katabi mo. Diba? Si Lord ang gumawa niyan. The Lord is creative. And if you are going to follow in that thought that you are created in the image and likeness of God, hey, you're also meant to create. Can you elbow the person beside you and just say, you're made to create. You're made to create. But you know the problem with society today? Especially the young kids. Can I hear it from the young kids? Yung mas malungkot pa. One more time. Hindi yung mga once upon a time. The young ones. You know the problem with society today is that we like to consume more than we create. Have you ever done this? You sat on a couch, you popped open your phone, and soon after you realized that 3 hours have gone by, you were just scrolling on your phone. Because the phone can get very interesting, right? The social media. But here's the thing. You were not meant to overconsume. You were meant to create. When you just start consuming and consuming, you reject and you neglect your God-given gift to create. God wants you to create. If you want to reclaim your God image that's in you, create every day. Strive to create something new. Don't just consume content from people because the problem there is also you might be copying the projection of that character that you're consuming, the content that they're projecting. So you're meant to create. Embrace creation, not just consumption. Here's the second thing. Second thing, let's put the slide. Embrace possibilities, not just liabilities. I love this point. Everybody say, embrace possibilities. We have a God who is unlimited. Do you believe that? A God who came and tore open the ceiling and remove the limitations. He broke the tradition because He wants to tell us that nothing is impossible through Him. Amen? That's why God is telling you today, don't just embrace the liabilities, you know, the limitations that the world has projected on you. Because, you know, that song that we always sing whenever I lift up the Bible, that verse, that comes from the Bible, by the way. We always say, Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. That is so beautiful. You know, I want to challenge you this week to step out in faith to discover things that you have never done. How do you get the courage? You declare that over your life. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. You know what that says? The lamp on my feet means that God is with you and every step that you take is another possibility. Even though you do not see the path, that's okay. But the presence of God is more important in you. So embrace possibilities more than liabilities. Here's the third one. Embrace personal encounters with God. Not just secondhand rumors. Something happened in the Bible. Let me read it to you. It comes from the book of John. Because Philip, one of the disciples, he was going around and then he saw his friend, Nathanael. And they said that, Nathanael, the Messiah that we have been praying for, we finally found him. He comes from Nazareth. And do you know how Nathanael replies? He says, Nazareth? Can anything good come from Nazareth? And you know what what Philip said? Come and see for yourself. Zach said it earlier. Touch and see. having God in your life is a personal invite. God is inviting you, my friend, to come and see. Don't just depend your faith on the faith of another person. Don't just base your salvation on somebody else's story that you're saved because somebody told you that God is good. No, have your own personal experience of God. Have your own mountaintop experience. Why? So that during those moments, you can have something to go back to again and again. So seek personal experiences with God, not just secondhand rumors. And here's the last one. This is my favorite. Embrace character and not just image. How many of you know, quick question, trivia question, who is the richest man in the entire world right now? Any guesses? Richest person. Don't Google. Who is the richest person? Give me some names. Come on, talk to me. Richest person. Bill Gates? Warren Buffett? I asked this question in another talk and they said, Bo Sanchez! Elon Musk? Who else? Steve Jobs? Okay. All good guesses. And they're very rich. But can I reveal who the richest person is? You probably don't know him because I didn't hear the right answer. The richest person in the world today, number one, according to Forbes list, is a man named Bernard Arnault. You know Bernard? Paring Bernard? He's a French businessman. You know how rich this guy is? His net worth is $235.3 billion. If you convert that to pesos, that's 12.8 trillion. I can't even wrap my head around all those zeros. He has enough to pay for the financial debt of our country. You know, or close to it. It's Bernard Arnault. You know Bill Gates. You know Elon Musk. You probably know Jeff Bezos from Amazon and a couple of other guys. Who in the world is Bernard Arnault? You don't know him by name, but if I tell you what he sells, you probably say, you want to know what he sells? He's the owner of Louis Vuitton and Dior, the brand. He recently bought the brand Dior from Christian Dior, so he now owns those brands. And Louis Vuitton is, you know Louis Vuitton, right? LV, as we call it. And, you know, if you ask this is interesting because I learned this from my cousin Angelique. And she said that the reason why Elon or Bernard Arnault is rich and he's the richest, it's not because people think, you know, he's selling luxury goods. I mean, you probably know how much an LV costs. It costs an arm and a leg. It's not because he's selling even to the ultra-rich market. That's not his market. Why? Because if his market is the ultra-rich, that's only like, you know, 0.006% of the entire global population. That's like 400,000 people. He'll only have one store. Where? In Zurich, Switzerland. But why is LV all over the world? Why? Because of the market that he sells to. It's not the ultra-rich. And here's a trivia. The ultra-rich, they don't use Louis Vuitton. They use non-branded clothes. Maybe that's the reason why they're ultra-rich. The market of LV is what you call the aspirational class. I don't have anything against LV, but this is the truth. It's called the aspirational class. Why? Because these people who love the product and they're very nice, they want a piece of luxury to own. So they can have something to say that, you know, I have a little bit of luxury with me. And that's why people spend a lot. Everybody say this with me. Aspiration is powerful. It is. Aspiration is powerful. That's the reason why many people do what they do. In fact, I asked this in our worship team once upon a time. I asked, why did you sign up to serve in the worship team? And you know what many of them said? Oh, because the singer there looked very cool. Or she sang very well. I want to do the same thing. And those are logical answers. But I wanted them to know deeper and go deeper into that reason. Because if you're here on stage and you're singing here every Sunday, or you're serving here at the feast and people look up to you, the last thing that I want is that people would aspire to dress up like you, to sing like you, to talk like you. Because more than your footwear are they inspired by your faith. More than your excellence in serving, do they feel and see and touch Jesus because of you? Aspiration is powerful. So copy character, not just the image of the person. Can I invite everybody to stand? Stretch your hands out, everybody. Ah, it's a long talk, I know. We want to reclaim the identity, the God image, the imago Dei that is in you already. You just don't know it yet, or maybe you've forgotten about it. But you know, let me share with you something very personal. When I started preaching here at the Feast, like many other preachers, you know, the secret or the trade secret to learning the craft is to copy from how other preachers do it. You borrow, you know, the style and the technique. So I studied the way our builders and our other preachers did it. And, you know, I tried some of the things that they did, but apparently I realized that I'm just going to be a poor version of the other preachers. Like, for instance, I'm a poor version of Brother John Ben Rodriguez. If you know him, he's very good at comedy, very humorous. You know, he just instantly knows a joke on the spot. Me, I have to prepare my jokes a week before I go on stage. And I practice it in the mirror, make sure that I laugh. And that's how I am. I'm a poor version of John Ben. I'm a poor version also of Doc Ryan Capitulo. You know, have you ever heard him sing his version of Thy Word? I mean, it's pangtanghalan ng kampyon. I mean, that's amazing. I'm also a poor version of Lep Sumera. The way he connects with the young people, my goodness. He knows the language of the young. Me, I have to take a crash course to understand your language, you know. Bet ko yan, Riz, Sus, Slay. I don't even know some of those languages. I'm also a poor version of Didoy. Didoy is such a good mentor when it comes to crucial conversations. Carefrontation, that's how we call it. Me, I'm also good at that at 100-kilometer radius. I'm not very good at confrontation, right, you know, face to face. I'm also a poor version of Brother Alvin Barcelona. The guy preaches so eloquently in Tagalog. Pakalalim, tas tagus sa puso. If you ask me to preach in Tagalog, my brain will buffer every 5 minutes. I just can't do it. I'm also a poor version of Brother Bo Sanchez. I mean, the wisdom of this guy is just beyond me. And plus, not to mention the fact that his K-drama game is just untouchable. The guy is amazing, right? When I look at it, you know, I'm just the worst version of all these preachers. I can't be like them. But you know what? I'm the best version of Audi Villaraza. Let me say the same thing to you. You're the best version of you. Nobody can do you. With all your complications and with all your uniqueness, nobody can be you. So what's my message? Be you. But don't just be you. Because on your own, you're an imperfect version. Be the Christ in you. That's the version you want. The Jesus in me. We want to reclaim that identity. The Jesus in me. Did you know that you cannot be played by any other person other than you? You're so unique. My son, he's got friends that are triplets. Faith, hope, and love. Let's show. Yeah. They're triplets. You thought I was kidding. That's okay. This is faith, that's love, and that's hope. If you put them together, I memorized that, by the way, because if we put them together, I can't tell them apart. But do you know how Ethan tells them apart? Hope has the smallest face. Faith, she has a birthmark here on the arm. And love, she's a hugger. She's the one hugging Ethan. She's the BFF of my son. God sent love to my son. faith, hope, and love. We're all unique in the eyes of God. So no matter what labels have been placed over your life, the names that you've been called, suplada, chismosa, bungangera, that's not who you are. Who you are a child of God. And you carry that image wherever you go, that imago Dei. We want to reclaim that identity in Christ. And so let me pray for you in the presence of God. Lift up your both hands in the air. Father, look us down here, your children, as we lift up our hands to acknowledge that your presence is before us. Help us to reclaim this lost identity, that because the world has projected all of these labels, all of these insinuations, all of these brandings on us, we've gotten lost. But today, Father, we realize that underneath the veil, we are just like you. We are loving like you. We are good like you. We are holy like you. And so we embrace this image. We know God. We need Jesus to be inside of us. And that identity to be locked here in our heart where nobody can take it from us, oh God. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for being with us. We pray more of you, Lord, in our life. Come. Come and be with us as we worship you in spirit and in truth. Come, Jesus. Come.
Take everything. It's all.
Spirit of the Lord is here with us today. I want to preach one last thing before we end. Before we commit to Jesus, our life, our past, present, and future, let me just preach this word from the book of Matthew. This will speak in your season of your life. If you're questioning some things, whether God loves you, whether there's some things that you hate about yourself, this is how God sees you. It talks about the baptism of Jesus in the Galilee. When John was surprised that Jesus would even approach him to be baptized, it says in chapter 4, verse 16, after his baptism, as Jesus came up out of the water, the heavens were opened and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, settling on him. And here it is in verse 17. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my dearly loved Son, who brings me great joy." Now, what is the significance of this? This is a time when Jesus had not performed any miracles yet. This is the time when his public ministry wasn't activated yet. And then God shows up in a voice after John baptizes him and says, "This is my Son, who I am well pleased, who brings me great joy." You want to know what my point is? Three people want to know. You want to know what my point is? I'm telling you, this is a game changer. This changes the way that you see how God sees you. This changed my life about how I see God see me. Before Jesus did anything for the Father already said, "This is my Son, who gives me great joy." So my friends, listen to this. Before you do anything for God, God already says, "You are my Son. I am well pleased by you. You don't need to do anything to earn my love, to be accepted, because you already are. While you were still a sinner, God already forgave you. God already loves you. So you don't need to earn it. You just need to accept it, to walk in it, to receive it." Who is with me? Are you ready to walk in the grace and the favor of God? Raise your hand if that's you. Raise your hand if that's you. Hallelujah. Father, look at all your children who love you, who worship you, who want to be with you. In this moment, I pray, Lord, that you would shift their hearts and return their identity. That identity that's in their DNA since the very beginning. You created them for a purpose, and you love them so much. Everybody say this with me. Lord, thank you for loving me, for accepting me, for embracing me, not for what I did, but because of what Jesus did. Thank you that you are my God. Change me like only you can, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, put your hands together, everybody. Celebrate life with Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. High five all the people that you can grab and tell them, copy Christ. Copy Christ. Amen and amen. Can we put our hands together for all the servants of the feast, everybody? Thank you for serving all of us. Before you go, everyone, just two announcements. First one, the sacrament of confession. It's available on the second floor. Make use of that. Go to God and ask for mercy and forgiveness and let it flow in and out of your life. Second announcement, for all the married people, raise your hand, married people. All right, this is for you. We have a couples retreat next week. If you're looking to grow and deepen your relationship and you're praying for an avenue or a channel where you can do that, we have a special retreat for all of you. I'll be there personally. Our leaders are going to be there. It's going to be a wonderful event where God is going to show up and heal the brokenness of your marriage and the issues that are hidden in the closets that's been shoved under the rug. We're going to pray for one another and we're going to renew your marriage. All right, married people, you can sign up there in the lobby. Lux Retreat. Last announcement also. Tatlo pala. All the first time attendees, raise your hand. Please stick around, all right? I'd love to meet you personally and pray for you, all right? After the session, just come forward here and we'd love to do that. Were you blessed today, everybody? Give me a shout if you were blessed. All right, let's worship the Lord one more time. Here we go. My invite for you. Come and see the goodness of the Lord. Come and taste the kindness and the mercy and the generosity of our good God. Come and see the Lord is alive here at the feast. Come and see. Next week, we'll have another amazing talk. Talk number 3 of our series, Race to Life. I hope that you can join us personally here. But hey, thank you for being there on the other side of the screen. We're blessed by your presence and we're blessed by your giving. Thank you for supporting our ministry week after week. May the Lord bless you even more this week. God bless you.